Hello everyone. Today I'm going to be showing you how to use the HAR parser at har.mcnc.org to troubleshoot problems with PAC files. First things first, I'll show you where to find this tool. You go to har.mcnc.org, and then you go to the first link, which is HAR Analyzer, and it shows this to you right here. There's on-site GRE, which is the GRE tunnel that traffic gets sent through when most students are on campus, and the way that we generally filter students off campus is with a PAC file. You can apply PAC files on site, but this is normally how it breaks down. So we're going to be looking at this off-site PAC. There are instructions down here on how to actually get a HAR file, but I'm also going to show you that in this video using Chrome. So the first thing we're going to look at is the problem site. So we're going to stop sharing here, start sharing here. So this is a test Chromebook. It has a PAC file applied to it. And if I try to go to funbrain.com, since all the students are home, the website can't be reached. Now this is not something that I'm blocking, and this is not the typical blocking page. When Zscaler is just normally blocking something like gambling.com, it's going to show, sorry, you don't have permission to visit. So this website just seems broken in some way. And aside from the fact that we couldn't go to gambling.com, you can also go to ip.zscaler.com, and it will show you that you are accessing the internet via Zscaler cloud. So we are being filtered through Zscaler right now. So now what we want to do, we know that we're being filtered through Zscaler and it's causing problems with FunBrain, which is a problem because we've asked students to play this one particular game on FunBrain that helps with multiplication. So what you're going to do now is get a HAR file. And the reason you get a HAR file is because as a page attempts to load, it's not only trying to go to that one page. There's something called redirects, and you can sometimes see them. You can see down in this bottom left corner, that gray bar that comes up. Those are all the different redirects on that page trying to load. And if any one of them is blocked by Zscaler for any reason, it can actually break the whole page. So that's what's happening here on FunBrain. So we need to get a HAR file that shows all of those redirects so that we can exclude them from the PAC file and let the page properly load. To do that, we need a working connection to funbrain.com, which means that we're going to stop sharing on the Chromebook. We're actually going to go back to my regular laptop that does not have a PAC file on it. You can use a Chromebook, you can use a PC, a Mac. It doesn't matter as long as it's a working connection. And if it's something that a student has to log into and the error happens when they log in, you're going to want to make sure you're capturing that HAR file through the whole process. So you want to make sure you can, from beginning to end, load the whole page while capturing a HAR file. So we're going to go to a new page, and you can either say inspect here, and that brings up this little console, and you're going to go to network. You can also get to it through this guy, these little three dots, say more tools, developer tools, and then you go to network. Final way you can do it is with control shift I, and that will pop up the developer tools as well. So then we want to check preserve logs. I already have it checked. And then we're going to type in our URL, funbrain.com, and let it fully load. You can see that it's now fully loading because I'm not on that Zscaler filtered website. And you see all these redirects that have nothing to do with FunBrain. So any one of these could be getting blocked and completely breaking the page. So then you right click on it and you say save all as HAR with content. In Firefox, it's like save content as HAR. There's different ways of phrasing it, but it's generally gonna be a right click and then something to do with saving as a HAR file. And then you can hit save. And so now that you have that HAR file, we're going to go back to our analyzer, choose our offsite PAC, funbrain.com, and This thing will now parse out all the important URL lines, and it will exclude any passwords or any, it just looks at URLs, it throws everything else away. So if you have to go through a login process, don't worry about uploading sensitive material. It completely scraps everything that's not just a URL. So now you have these nice list of PAC files that have been truncated and aggregated. What you see here, this is just the raw data that has been pulled out of your HAR file. So these are all of the different URLs that the analyzer is seeing. And then this is showing you how it's truncated. So anything that's www.google.com/ will get just aggregated down to google.com. If there are several Playwire things, they'll get aggregated down. So then you have a final list of aggregated URLs. And that's important because you don't want the same URL blocked several times in different ways. You want to make sure that it's just in your list once, or it can kind of cause just readability issues more than anything. So now that you have this list, we're going to go see our PAC. We can basically just copy this. You can put it into something like Notepad if you want, just to make sure the formatting is gone from the web page. And down here you can see, if you're not sure how to now put it into a PAC file, there's another instruction page, but I'm just going to show you how to do it here. So we're going to go to Zscaler. From our dashboard, we're going to go to Administration, Hosted PAC Files, and I have been using FinTest. So we're going to edit that, and then you can see I've already excluded Zoom so that I could do this presentation. So right below that, I am going to make sure that I have all of this copied. I'm going to paste that in, make sure that it looks good. And if you already have anything, like if I had more than just Zoom in here, I'd want to double check and make sure, again, I'm not duplicating anything. And again, that's mostly just for readability, but it's a good habit to get into. And then you want to verify. This is verifying syntax, and that's all it's verifying. It's not verifying that it's the perfect PAC file, but you definitely want to hit that button, because if you upload a broken PAC file, it will just still take it. So you definitely need to verify it, or you might not understand why something's not working. It does get applied immediately, so make sure that you are either testing these things in a separate OU, or you've already tested and you're certain that this is what you want to do. And we're going to hit activate. So this PAC file should immediately have made the change. So we can stop sharing here and go back over to our Chromebook. And look at that. I guess it just loaded while we were there, but it's already loaded back up. We are still on. We're still accessing via the cloud, but now we can see that FunBrain has loaded. So that is how you are going to use the HAR analyzer to help fix PAC files, to make sure that off-campus traffic is not being broken or filtered incorrectly.